I want this church to be a peaceful place and have God have people look at different ways to look after the earth and pick up garbage.
In 10 years, I hope that the church will be more high-tech and have extra room built into it so that there's a large area of space that more stuff can be done in, such as this film.
How we have compassion towards homeless people or vulnerable people. But we also have compassion towards each other when some of our members are sick or are grieving or whatever it might be. So that's what really unites us as a community, and I think that's important. I think in that, there's an important message about how we become a community in the future, in that it's focused on a quiet resistance to violence and to exploitation, and or a gentle resistance, I should say. It should never be quiet. It's a gentle resistance to those things, and we focus on God's love and compassion to all people. So how I see that working out in concrete ways is that I would wish that the Anglican Church became clear about its mission, that it is, it's not so much about sexual politics as it is about economic politics and about redistribution of wealth and what it means to really live out God's life in our lives. And that has something to do with the people on our streets and the people in the rest of the world that sometimes our society is killing and exploiting. So a clear statement from the Anglican Church about that would make me proud to be a part of this organization in the future.
So. I believe that right now our church is in a bit of an indecision about the gay lesbian marriages, and that is definitely one thing I would love to see resolved by 2019, because there so many people that have churches of their own but can't get married there because of that, which is quite upsetting. And if that could finally be resolved, I would be very, very proud to be part of this church. I would also be much happier if we could figure out how to more ways to help homeless people and people with AIDS or other infections, and that would make me even more proud to be part of the Anglican Church.
Where do I want the Anglican Church of Canada to be in 2019? I want it to be right here. The church for me is something that's always been part of my life. I'm a cradle Anglican, I don't know any other way. I'm a meat and potatoes Christian, what is and what is isn't, and that's how I am. But I know that I'm not alone because the church is with me. And I want the church's doors to always be open and to include every age group. The life of a church is only balanced when every age group is there to witness by their very presence, to witness with their joy, to witness with their sorrow. And the church gives us the framework that some of us need to live out our ministry. We wouldn't have the strength to do it on our own. We need the strength of the people around us, the witness that they give us, the example they give us, the encouragement they give us. And so I'm looking for the church to be there in 2019 to enliven me as a person, to find a place where I can serve, to find a place where I can continue to learn, and that the church encourages me to continue to think and to learn and to pray and to praise in any language and in any spirit. And that's the church that's going to be waiting for me in 2019.
My vision and prayer would be for healing, for the church, for wholeness, and that the church across this great country would have the vision to have open doors, open hearts, and open minds. I want to see us dance. I think the church has the power to be representative of the counterculture in our society. I think the counterculture in our society is what tells us about our society, and I think there's a bridge that needs to be built between the counterculture and the mainstream culture, and I think the church can build that bridge. And I think we can do it through art and through music and through expressing ourselves and through just being here. And I think inclusion and listening to the counterculture is where I'd like to see the church, what I'd like to see the church doing in 2019.
My hopes for this church is that we'll have moved on spiritually as well as, like, literally. I mean, because right now we're at kind of crossroad with, like, all these difficulties in front of us, and people are leaving the church because of gay and lesbian marriage and stuff, because they're either against it or because they're for it, but they can't, but it's not happening fast enough. So I just hope that, you know, we move on and accept gay and lesbian marriages, and that really our church just grows spiritually.
By 2019, I hope that the church will be a truly inclusive church. I hope that there are many more families involved in churches. And I hope that the church is more representative of our multicultural population. So Christchurch does have lots of different ethnic groups represented. But I would like it to be richer in that way. I want that all groups be welcome, that we reach out in acts of justice in areas of poverty and homelessness and the many other concerns that people have in their lives today. Truly extending God's love to all these people.
What's missing, and this is what I'd like to see the church move towards, is a return to community. Cyprian, back in the late 3rd century, said the purpose of, or there is no salvation outside of the church, and redefined the mission of the church as being that salvation. And according to Paul Tillich, before that it was a community of saints. And I think we need to go back to where we support each other as a group for the service of the greater world.